know how angry people can get at video games. Sometimes you see the worst side of somebody when they're playing games. And I'm willing to bet that plenty of you guys watching this video have actually flipped out plenty of times at your favorite game. But have you ever wondered if there's a way to avoid all that anger? Is there a way to avoid all that rage? What's up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s. And today, we're going to be taking a look at and counting down 10 easy ways you could avoid raging out while you're playing video games.
We are running a $200 Amazon gift card giveaway the entire month. All you have to do to enter is like this video, be subscribed, turn on your notifications, and leave a comment why you want to win it with your Twitter handle attached. I will announce the winner at the end of the month on Twitter.
One thing you should never rage out at is free money. Make sure you guys enter this giveaway. It runs all month. Make sure you're subscribed with your notifications on. And now, let's go over some easy tips or ways that you can keep your center, keep your level of cool, if you will, when it comes to playing video games. At number 10, and this is going to sound very cliche, okay? But it actually does work. Take deep breaths. When you get angry, you tense up and your heart rate tends to elevate. Taking deep breaths can quickly return these two things back to a neutral state. This is used everywhere besides video games. Well, why not implement it when it comes to you getting mad on games? Because trust me, just think for a second, close your eyes and come to that rage out moment that you've had where you can't get past a certain level or you continue to die by a corner camper in Call of Duty, okay? Pause the game. Or just turn it off completely, put down the controller, and just take some deep breaths. Let your body return to its normal resting state before you jump back into that game. Now, this one is up for debate because some people say reach higher, aim higher, all that, and I totally get that. But hear me out on this. At number 9, lower your expectations. With video games, it's pretty easy for us to set unrealistic goals for our performance. How many times have you said to yourself, "This is the game where I get that nuke," or "I'm going to go flawless in this match," and then you just got mad because you didn't succeed and you got frustrated. A good way to avoid making yourself angrier than you need to be is just to look at your expectations for your performance and make them realistic. If you're setting huge unrealistic goals for yourself, you're only setting yourself up to fail and get angrier. Don't push yourself too hard. And while we're on that topic, well, you'll see here in a second, but also try to have fun with the game. Okay, once again, some people will argue and say, if you're not first, you're last, and it's all about winning. I get that, but we're talking about trying to avoid the rage moments, okay? Number 8, don't play to win. Video games are meant to be fun. They seriously are. I know a lot of people forget that, but the word game is in the title of the thing. So you should probably try to keep that in mind next time you're playing and getting a little bit heated. Rather than demanding wins over and over from yourself, maybe just relax and play to have fun. Set some fun, realistic goals. Instead of going super try hard all the time, maybe go for stylish combos or trick shots. I don't know. Something that would be more just fun. The key word here is fun. Don't take the game so seriously and play to have fun, not only to win. Winning's great, I get that. But sometimes it's out of your control when it comes to video games. No one wins every single time, and expecting consistent wins will only disappoint you, especially in online games. At number 7, and this goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway, take a break. If you're playing a game and you start feeling that rage boil up inside of you, the best thing to do is walk away. Simply walk away, turn it off for a little while. Most games have a save point if you're playing a single player, and if you're playing multiplayer, it doesn't matter, okay? Not forever, but also not just for a few minutes. It's probably a good idea to turn the game off and not touch it for the rest of the day. Go outside, spend some time with friends, find something else to do. If you find yourself constantly getting angry at a certain game, which we all have, I know I have, maybe even take a few days break from that game to let yourself calm down. Getting angry is, it's admittedly part of the fun with certain games, but if it's happening over and over and over, that's a bad cycle, and you need to break that cycle and let your brain relax a little bit. And case in point for me is Clash Royale. I play the game religiously, and it's the only game right now that can make me just instantly go furious. So sometimes I have to just put it down, put my phone down, and come back to it later. At number six, this one applies to online multiplayer games, which also tend to be the most frustrating and rage-inducing games on the market. Mute the lobby. It's a beautiful thing, people. With an online game, it's not the computer that's beating you, rather than a real person, which will make you mad. It's definitely not a great feeling when the same person keeps killing you over and over again, your nemesis, if you will. But if it only gets worse when that person starts talking smack and makes you feel even worse. Well, that's what the mute button's for, people. Many online games even have a mute all button for quick silence. So if you feel yourself getting angry at the game, it's probably a good idea to go ahead and mute all the other players in the lobby, even if they aren't talking. So that way, you don't run the risk of them talking trash and basically making you even saltier, getting under your skin. Cracking into the top five, this is a crazy concept for some gamers, but let's say it anyway. Go outside. That's right. Go outside. Just take a short walk. If you're heated at a game, just get away. There's something about feeling the fresh air of the outdoors that can instantly calm people down if they've been inside gaming all day. If you feel yourself boiling up with rage, maybe turn the console off and go take a walk. If you have a dog, walk the dog, or maybe go outside and grab the mail. Take the trash out. Whatever you want to do. A short little trip outside can actually work wonders for your mind state and actually have you more focused with more clarity when you come back in to play the game. And if you're at that point and you need to get up and go outside, I would suggest more than just a couple minutes. That's probably one of those points where you just want to take a couple hours or even more break away from the game. You guys are going to love this next one, and it may sound a little unproductive, but it's a good plan anyway in the right situation. And number four. Find something to hit, okay? Hitting things is a part of video game rage, which often leads to broken controllers, dented desks, TVs, and you know what I'm talking about with that smasher gaming rage. It's probably a good idea to have something nearby that you can hit without doing any real damage. Let's be honest. Would you rather smash a controller or a pillow? Scuff controllers are expensive, my people, and if you know you're going to hit something when you get mad, it's better to come prepared than to try to bundle all of that in. Keep a pillow somewhere or something smashable nearby in preparation. I actually have a punching bag hanging right behind it. I'm not going to lie. There have been times in games where I've stopped, got up, wailed on the punching bag a little bit, and then sat back down. It's better the punching bag than for me to break a $200 controller or a TV or something around, because you probably have electronics laying around everywhere in your gaming setup, and you don't want to break those. This may seem cheap, but hey, sometimes you have to do what you have to do. And number three, and I want you to let me know in the comment section if you've ever done this, lower the difficulty settings. And one of the most humiliating things for gamers is to admit defeat and lower the difficulty of a certain game. But I'll tell you right now, I've done it. We all want to beat the game on the toughest possible difficulty to truly master all that it had to offer. But sometimes we just end up frustrating ourselves by not really allowing ourselves to master the mechanics of the game before jumping into the huge challenges that it has in store. Remember, the lower difficulties are there for a reason. If you're playing a game on high difficulty and it's really getting under your skin, maybe it's a good idea to lower it and really master those lower difficulties before jumping back into the deep end with the higher ones. Just, you're usually playing by yourself. Don't worry. Nobody's going to judge you. At number two, life weights. Many people get angry at games, and there's nothing wrong with that, but a lot of the problems arise when people don't know what to do with that anger. How do you channel it? A really good and efficient way is to go work out. I told you I had a punching bag behind me. I also have an elliptical and a bench press weight bench right behind me. Physical activity has proven time and time again to lift people's moods when they get upset or angry. And anger will only get you more motivated to work out harder. So it's a win-win situation. If you suck at a video game, go get in shape. I know that sounds crazy, but it's true. If you have a gym nearby or if you have some weights, whatever, there's plenty of things you can use to work out with and burn off some of that anger. Okay, the final thing today is really simple for you guys. Remember that it's just a game. One of the easiest things to forget while playing a game is that it's a game. Games are meant to be fun and enjoyable, and while we do take them pretty seriously from time to time, that does not change the fact that they are indeed just games. Some games are intended to get a rise out of you, and some of them are meant to be ultra competitive. But at the end of the day, none of that really matters. So no matter how seriously you take your favorite game or how much rage it gets out of you, just remember, you can drop it as easily as you picked it up, and that's it. You can walk away from it anytime you want to. There you go, guys. Those are 10 easy ways to avoid rage while playing video games. If this was insightful or helpful at all, drop a like on the video. Let me know in the comment section, what is your biggest rage out moment? What game do you rage out to the most? There's a playlist below with all the other top 10s that go up. And I just want to say thank you to everybody that watches these on the daily. I'll see you guys tomorrow for a new video.